This is a summary of the CPIC dosing guideline for phenytoin, phosphenytoin, and variation in the genes HLA-B and CYP2C9. This guideline was last updated in August 2020. Due to the increased risk of severe cutaneous adverse reactions, the guideline recommends that phenytoin is not used by phenytoin-naive patients with the HLA-B star-1502 allele. Additionally, a reduced maintenance dose should be considered for CYP2C9 poor metabolizers or CYP2C9 intermediate metabolizers with an activity score of 1. This is the PharmGKB phenytoin pharmacokinetics pathway. A link to the pathway is provided in the description below this video. Phenytoin and phosphenytoin are anti-epileptic drugs. Phosphenytoin is a prodrug of phenytoin and is covered by the same recommendations as phenytoin in this guideline. Phenytoin is metabolized by CYP2C9 to form inactive metabolites. In CYP2C9 intermediate or poor metabolizers, metabolism of phenytoin is reduced. This can lead to an increased risk of drug toxicity. There are over 70 defined CYP2C9 alleles, known as star alleles. Star alleles are characterized by their rate of function relative to the star 1 allele, which is designated as a normal function allele. As part of this guideline update, activity values were assigned to different CYP2C9 allele functions. This is shown in the table at the top of the slide and can also be found in the CYP2C9 allele functionality table available at the PharmGKB and CPIC websites. Diplotypes of CYP2C9 star alleles can be assigned to a metabolizer phenotype, as shown in the table at the bottom of the slide and in Table 2 of the guideline. Note that as more evidence becomes available, new star alleles can be added, and the functional definition of some star alleles may change. An important caveat for all genotyping tests is that any alleles which are not detected in the assay are designated as star 1. This can include rare increased function, reduced function, and non-functional alleles, which are not routinely screened for in some genotyping tests. Further information about CYP2C9 alleles can also be found at the PharmVar website at www.pharmvar.org. A link to PharmVar is also given in the description below this video. The HLA-B star-1502 allele has been linked to Stevens-Johnson syndrome or toxic epidermal necrolysis induced by phenytoin. The exact mechanism by which HLA-B star-1502 interacts with phenytoin to cause SGS10 is not well defined, but is thought to involve CD8 positive T cells and the phenytoin arine oxide metabolite. Genotyping results for HLA-B star-1502 are reported as either negative for patients with no copies of the allele or positive for patients with one or two copies of the allele. These are the CPIC dosing recommendations for phenytoin. Patients who are positive for the HLA-B star-1502 allele, regardless of their CYP2C9 phenotype, are at an increased risk of developing phenytoin-induced SGS10. If the patient is phenytoin-naive, phenytoin and phosphenytoin should not be used. This is a strong recommendation. Other aromatic anticonvulsants have weaker evidence linking SGS10 with the HLA-B star-1502 allele. However, caution should still be used in selecting an alternative agent. If the patient has previously used phenytoin continuously for longer than 3 months without incidence of SGS10, future use of phenytoin can be considered with caution. This is an optional recommendation. Be aware that previous tolerance of phenytoin is not indicative of tolerance to other aromatic anticonvulsants. The following recommendations apply only to patients who are negative for the HLA-B star-1502 allele. Patients who are CYP2C9 normal metabolizers will have normal metabolism of phenytoin. Typical dosing strategies can be used in these patients. This is a strong recommendation. Patients who are CYP2C9 intermediate metabolizers with an activity score of 1.5 will have slightly reduced metabolism of phenytoin. However, this does not appear to have any impact on side effects. Typical dosing strategies can be used in these patients. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients who are CYP2C9 intermediate metabolizers with an activity score of 1 will have reduced metabolism of phenytoin and are more likely to experience drug toxicity. an approximately 25% reduction in maintenance doses should be considered for these patients. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients who are CYP2C9 poor metabolizers will have reduced metabolism of phenytoin and are more likely to experience drug toxicity. An approximately 50% reduction in maintenance doses should be considered for these patients. This is a strong recommendation. The dosing recommendations for phenytoin can be found in Table 3 of the guideline. This guideline has been annotated on the PharmGKB website. This includes a drop-down menu where an activity summary can be given for specific combinations of alleles. The activity summary includes implications for the patient's response to phenytoin, the appropriate dosing recommendation for the specific genotype, and the strength of that recommendation. Remember that variation in other genes, in addition to demographic and clinical factors, including concomitant medications, can affect treatment. It remains the responsibility of the clinician to determine the best course of treatment for a patient. CPIC and PharmGKB assume no responsibility for any injury to persons or damage to persons or property arising out of or related to any use of CPIC's guideline or for any errors or omissions. The guideline itself and supplementary information are freely available at the PharmGKB and CPIC websites. You can access relevant pages using the links in the description below this video.